is my song different? Take care of each other and take care of yourselves. I love you so much.
Hey guys, what's up? And welcome to my trip to Atlanta for the Joshua Bassett Concert. Here we go. So as a birthday present, my mom and Mimi got tickets to the Joshua Bassett It's Complicated tour. I am just like so thankful and happy because it has been a dream of mine to see him in person. So if you've never been on my channel before, I'm Amelia. I live in Florida and unfortunately Joshua didn't have a concert there, but he has one in Atlanta, Georgia, so we will be traveling there for that. So I'm gonna vlog the whole weekend in Atlanta, but if you're here just for the Joshua Bassett concert, I put in chapters on this video. So just go to the Joshua Bassett concert chapter, and there you go. But if you're here for the whole thing, let's get right into it. It's about 3:30 in the morning, and we're just gonna leave for Atlanta. We're driving, and the ride is about like 7 hours long. I don't know how much of Atlanta we'll actually see because we're staying in Buckhead for the concert. And then on Sunday, it's Palm Sunday, and we're not gonna be back in time to go to our church. So we're gonna find a church in Atlanta or like Buckhead and go to church there for Palm Sunday. But I think the weekend is gonna be a success. I'm so excited for this concert. Okay, so let's just get into it. Here we go.
Life is a winding road. No telling where it goes. Driving. Days and nights won't stop for traffic lights. And I really wanna know, really wanna know if I'll ever figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. Say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down. Jumping from cliffs so high, trusting our wings to fly. Sometimes we're crashing down, but we get up and start from the ground. And I really wanna know, really wanna know if I'll ever figure out where the road goes.
Yay!
Even if I'm falling.
Hey guys, we are finally in Atlanta at the hotel. And we like put all our stuff in the room. The room is so cute. It's so cute, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mimi's gonna go to the pool, but me and mom are gonna go in the city, find like a Dollar Tree or something like that, and get a poster, cause we're gonna make posters. And then we're gonna eat. Then we'll be back and get ready for the concert. But the concert is at 8, but the doors open at 7. But it's like, you have to stand, so you want like a front row standing seat, so people like wait. So I think we're gonna get there around 6.
I'm gonna pass it now to see how.
Oh, like, we're gonna pass it?
Yeah, cause it's only. Oh.
I will keep on searching for my highs.
People are like around the corner waiting. Oh, I hope we don't get like the back.
You can say I lost my mind.
We saw the venue and all these people are waiting outside, so now we feel like we have to go wait outside because like we want to get in there early. So we got Pizza Hut pizza. So excited.
Show them.
Turn right, then turn left.
You turn right and then turn left.
Hey guys, so we're all ready. This is my outfit. These necklaces. I put JB for Joshua Bassett. This shirt, these jeans, Converse, and then I really want to get merch there, so hopefully I do. Alright, we're about to leave and here we go. Hi guys, we're at the venue and this is literally his bus and there is his poster. I'm so excited.
Something about you.
Okay guys, so unfortunately they're not gonna let my camera in because it's like a professional camera. So I'm gonna bring my phone in and just like put my phone to the highest like HD or whatever. So hopefully it looks good, but yes, I'll see you in line.
It is the windiest day ever.
keep each other afloat. We both know where this gonna go.
The line has moved up a little bit.
It is so far.
Hand on my cheek, going 95 at night. You're free, you don't see, you're exactly what I like.
We're about to go in.
Exactly what I like. With your hand on my cheek, going 95 at night.
Now I'm in the merch line.
Oh,
jump and I saw someone. Live in cities that I like to live in, like the entertainment capital of the world. You might have heard of it. I don't take this moment to remind you guys that what people think about you and what they say about you does not matter. When you know what it's a fan and your friends leave, then they weren't really your friends in the first place. So. Here's my song.
Yeah.
to have. Oh, come on. Oh, thanks. This is a perfect segue. Thank you, sir. Back in 2018, my roommates stormed into my room and they're like, Josh, wake up, check the phone, check the phone. And I checked the phone and it was my agent and they're like, hey, Disney wants you for this little show. And it's a testament to the fact that we're all here right now, so join me in singing Finally Free. Featuring Tiara. Called Joshua Bassett. I couldn't include all the songs, but I wanted to put little pieces in, so I did a medley. And, I gotta catch my breath. But yeah, sing along to the parts you know, enjoy the parts you don't. I wanna take some water, so just give me a second.
Thank you.
heaven was something you had to wait until you died to experience. And I've learned recently through Jesus Christ that... Again, being in Atlanta is great, but you know, every city I'm in means I have to be in a different hotel every night. And that can be sad sometimes, so here are sad songs in the hotel. So if you have a song in the heart, if you have a dream, if you have an idea, follow up, baby. It's like all of that. That being said, for this next part of the show, just about where that white iPhone is, there should be an X on the floor. You see the X. I need complete cooperation, everybody. Please do not push. Please do not push. But I need a path from here to right there.
Common sense tells me it's the girl with eyes.
Not a real song.
That's tells me it's the girl with eyes.
No,
common sense ain't calling when you love the time.
Woo! Yes, sound great. Yes, great. Back to the stage. Shout out to the security and everyone for making this. No, but on a slightly more serious note, back in 2021, I was diagnosed with septic shock and heart failure, which is crazy when you're 20. The doctor said that if I hadn't checked in within 12 hours, I wouldn't have made it, which is Again, a crazy thing to hear. When I was sitting in the hospital bed waiting for my mom to get there, I realized that if their projections were right, if I hadn't checked in, I never would have made amends with my mom, I never would have made amends with my dad, I never would have made amends with my family, and like countless other people. Not sure why you're cheering about that, but... I'm just teasing. But again, it put a lot into perspective me of just how much things can change and how fast they can change in this life. And I just want to take this moment to remind you guys, if you have a loved one that maybe you've been separate from, unless it's unsafe, please do whatever you can to mend that. I promise you it's not worth holding on to. Because there was all these reasons that I had, and then in that moment I realized that all of them were not worthwhile. Like, it was all ridiculous. So it really did give me that perspective and the ability to mend my relationship with my family. And the other thing I want to say is that I was fortunate enough that I had my mom to call as my lifeline. Like, you know, but not everybody has a lifeline. So I just want to encourage you guys to reach out to somebody who you think might need it and just let them know that they're a lifeline. And the first person that came to mind, you can do that after the show. But the interesting thing too is when I was in the hospital, my vitals weren't getting any better. And as soon as they left, I didn't believe in God at the time, but I out loud, I said, I need help. And as soon as I said, I need help, the doctors came back in, they checked my stuff, and the doctors said that my recovery was miraculous. Those were the words that they used. At the time, I didn't know who to thank. I now know who to thank. The larger message is just, you know, ask for help if you need help, and don't be afraid to reach out to whoever that lifeline might be for you. So here is my song, Lifeline. Mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, I was by far the worst that I've ever been. It's fixed, yay. I just want to give a trigger warning real quick about what I'm about to talk about, because, you know, not a lot of people talk about it, and it's sort of a silent struggle that way too many of us go through. I mean, the percentages of this mental health stuff is like through the roof, and it's ridiculous. It's not ridiculous. What I mean is the fact that we don't talk about it is ridiculous. But after I got out, I remember saying out loud, again, trigger warning, that I wish I hadn't made it out. And there were times where I was so underground and so underwater, and I could not see light at the end of the tunnel, and every day was exhausting, and I never thought that I was going to make it out. And I just want to acknowledge that now. For anyone who might be in that period or in that season, I want to give you the hope that I am by far the best I've ever been in my entire life, the happiest, the most happy. If I could give you any encouragement, if you're in that place now, or if you're in that place shortly, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. You will make it out all right, all in due time. So hang on tight.
We love you! nice. Who was that? Oh, yo, shout out. Thank you so much. So sweet. Yeah, yeah. Someone want to get that for the team? Thank you. Okay, you guys. Now's the part of the show where we do a new cover every night. Bear with me here. We just worked this out. I couldn't decide between two songs, so I decided to do both at the same time. Forget the lyrics. Please don't kill me. I'm sorry. We're gonna try this. We can practice it once. So. Secret and la 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 and all that stuff. It's also important to acknowledge that, you know, I've done my own things that I'm not proud of. So one night I was up too late talking to the moon. I wrote a little song called I'm Sorry. So.
I can't imagine how you're doing these days. Sure wasn't perfect back then. I'll be first to admit, but it was better than being strangers again. Oh, I'll come too late talking to the moon. Ooh, writing songs I can't sing to you. Cause ever since that day, the things I didn't say, they haunt me. Oh, and I know that I'm to blame, so go ahead and blame it on me. Oh, I know that I'm too late, but I'll say I know that I'm too late, but I'll say it anyway. I'm sorry, yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
We love you!
So I wrote Would You Love Me Now and I'm Sorry in the same like 24-hour period. Couple days later, I wrote this next one. That's all the introduction I got for it. So without further ado, here's my song, Different. Had a change around me before change would happen, and I'm learning very quickly that the change starts within me and is echoed out from there. And so, again, I want to remind everybody that in order to build a beautiful city, that takes each of us stepping up to the plate and the burden that we have. So I just wanted to sing a song from Godspell. It's called Beautiful City.
Oh my God.
We sing our last song, and I wrote this song in a place where, like I said earlier, I really felt like I was never going to get out of it. And I personally have, again, found my freedom through Jesus Christ. But whatever it is that's been chaining you down, it's been keeping you way down, I promise, it does not have to take all of you. So, tonight, whatever it is that's still in you, if there's bitterness, unforgiveness, if there's something you're going through, I'm inviting you to scream at the top of your lungs. Let all of that, as if it doesn't have to take all of you. Here it is, suddenly free.
Take it all back if I
I'm just so happy, like,
oh my goodness.
Okay, so I thought the concert was amazing. I wasn't in the front, but I still enjoyed it as much as I would have been if I was in the front, you know what I mean? It was so good, and he just like went everywhere, and it was so funny. I don't know if I got it on video, but hopefully I did, but it was like, we were all like, one more song, and then he like threw the microphone, and he was like, where am I? Girl. It was so funny because he was like in the back, but anyway, it was just the best concert ever. I mean, I've only been to one other concert, but still, it was just amazing. And I got his merch. This is like his official tour merch. It says Bassett, the Complicated Tour 2023, and is brown. So cute. And then after the show, the best thing happened. We were waiting to like see him, and we were like, oh, he'll probably just go to his bus. He had a show in Nashville yesterday, he's tired, but then he came out and talked to all of us. Like, we were in the back of the line, and we were at this point where, like, a couple of feet in front of us, they said that they were gonna stop him from, like, talking to anybody, and then he was like, no, I want to talk to them. So then, like, I got to talk to him, and I hugged him, and, like, it was just amazing. Like, I met him, and then I gave him this letter I wrote. The main poster that I held the entire time that said, you're our darling, because he's always saying, like, darling in his songs, talking about girls, but, like, he's our darling, you know? And so that was, like, the main poster I held up because most of the songs he had darling in it. So then in the back, I wrote him a letter, and then I gave it to him, and then he opened it, and it was so cute. He has the letter. It's so cute. I'm just so happy. And it was a 10 out of 10 experience. And thanks to Mimi for driving us all the way here. Thanks to Mom for, like, you know, taking me there, like, being with me. And yeah, I was so excited. And that is my whole Joshua Bassett tour vlog that I'm gonna keep going with this whole weekend. But if you just came to see the tour, thank you so much for watching. And if you're here for the whole thing, here we go. Good morning, everybody. It is the next day, and we are going to jump in the pool really quick because we have checkout at 12, and it's like 11:20. So we're just gonna go over a little bit.
Is it in that pool?
Oh my gosh.
What? Oh, it is!
What?
Mom! Oh, the Joshua Bassett! All the Joshua Bassett videos! No!
Why?
No!
It's working!
It's working!
Wait, here,
it's working!
Get a towel. What in the heck?
How did it fall in? I promise I did not do that.
I think when I...
No! Staying alive, staying alive.
Wait, wait.
Just say hi.
What's up?
Concierge.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hi. So as you've seen, my phone's on the pool, but it's still kind of like working. So we're gonna put basmati rice in. Ready. Hopefully this is right.
I think it'll be okay, hopefully. We'll keep you updated.
Right?
Hi. We're going to breakfast at the Pancake House. To the cathedral for church for Palm Sunday.
They gathered by the sea, sand people anxiously. Not once did speak to me when tides came, did not flee. The east spoke the same, had the same dream, same pain and same feelings, staring at the sea. Was left of me.
Hi! We just came out of a beautiful Palm Sunday Mass.
Mm-hmm. Okay, guys, so unfortunately, we're on the way home now because I have school tomorrow and I still have to like sleep and get ready and stuff. But we're just like exploring here and then we're gonna head back to Florida, so.
Tried to shout, but when in doubt, the facade of the sea staring back at me. Each led like sheep, stepped foot to sea, drowning oh so patiently. Sand people sit and wait anxiously.
She
doesn't wanna get out of Atlanta. She likes it. Atlanta.
Okay guys, this will be the end of the vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Hope you enjoyed the Joshua Bassett concert. He's literally the sweetest person ever. And thank you so much to my mom and Mimi who made this possible. And I'm just so happy and thankful I got to experience it. Like, comment, and subscribe if you want. And follow me on my Instagram. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!